Drama, despair, delight, expect them all and so much more. We are all set for day one of a brand new season. Bournemouth against Southampton. I'm Peter Drury and this is Jim Beglin.
Hello Peter and hello to everyone watching. For me, it's a real thrill to be here.
Bournemouth against Southampton. So away we go then. Jim, who do you reckon is pivotal?
I'll go with all 6'4" of Graziano Pella. His size and strength lends itself to good ball retention, and he's a great foil for the movement of smaller teammates to pick up the layoffs and flick-ons.
Yes, he'd be my pick too. It's going to be all about how they get the best out of him.
It was a little difficult for him to pick exactly the right option there. There were so many in the box. I don't think we should be totally surprised that he actually went for the shot in the end.
Where to from here? Steered out wide. A chance! Looking to shoot!
Teller.
Bournemouth are putting their opponents under a lot of pressure in the early stages. Coleman. Looks like a good ball through. Oh, it's opened up nicely for him. Was physical, no nonsense, and it had to be.
Well, we were unlikely to see a goal then because there were so many players crowding out that danger area. I think something very special was going to be needed.
Bournemouth satisfied for now at 0-0. Now here's the through ball. Keeper barely had to move.
Yeah, I'm sure he was trying to place it in the corner of the net, but he's not likely to score by firing straight at the keeper.
Coleman. Schneiderlin. Jose Fox. Burton. To slip it through. It's a forceful run down the right, but he's short of options now. Keeps everyone guessing. Chance! that's it. He's missed another one.
Bournemouth have been enjoying as good an attacking spell as you could wish for, and yet they've been incredibly wasteful. I mean, they could have wrapped it up by now, and it's not going right for them.
Strong punch. Can he find a finish now? Minutes gone. A chance! The ball's come loose and the chase is on. Klein, Tadic. Gets into some space. Now the pass. He's got away with one there. Bertrand. Coleman. Brought forward. What does he try from here? I think that's offside. Yes, it is. Bournemouth will be quite pleased with the way things have been going, Jim, I think.
More than quite pleased, Peter. They'll be doing cartwheels if they can get to half-time without conceding. But I have to pay respect to such a great defensive setup, individually and collectively outstanding.
Coleman. Half-time getting close now. This is promising. Coleman. Schneiderlin. Coleman. Driving on, he could shoot here. And it's half-time here. How would you review the first half?
I think it's been a very impressive defensive effort. They've never been broken down and contained the opposition attack extremely well.
Interesting half, just missing goals. So don't be surprised if the second half brings a change to the scoreline at the break. 0-0. And the action is back on the way.
Bournemouth can feel really happy with themselves. The scoreline doesn't back it up, but they've played with urgency and purpose and can't afford to lose patience in this second half. They've got to persevere.
Tadic. Wanyama. And it's Klein. Klein with the ball through. Here it comes. Bertrand cuts it out. Coleman. Bertrand gets it away. To the flank. Tries a through ball. Caught offside that time.
That was very, very close. He was just offside.
Jose Font. Bournemouth doing really well to frustrate them so far, Jim.
Well, in turning up for this game, we fully expected them to come under huge pressure. That certainly has been the case. But what spirit and togetherness they've displayed to keep their goal intact.
Oh, they really are doing well in the face of all this pressure. Oh, and they really should have been made to pay. Repelled by the keeper. Ball's loose, who's getting there? It's on a plate. Has a swing at it. Well, he should have done better, and he knows it.
Well, when he struck that, he must have thought it was going in. Such are the margins of success and failure in this game. That was so close.
Past the turn on opening day, and still no breakthrough. Promising move that, good inroads into enemy territory, but no joy. It is still anyone's game, 0-0. Just the goalkeeper to beat. Breakthrough arrives at last!
Oh, that was a close call, but for me, he timed his run to absolute perfection there to stay just onside. And he's still a lot to do, you know, but I think he's tucked that away really well.
Bournemouth look as though they're about to make a change.
Substitution on the field.
So the deadlock broken by the underdogs. Tries lifting it over. Bournemouth may be thinking about substitutions now. They still have two available. Good interception. So they got the only goal to make it 1-0. Wanyama. Klein. Schneiderlin. It's a loose ball. Gets on the end of it.
There's a real confidence about them, and they look as though fitness levels and energy are still strong, but they have to maintain possession. Can't afford to lose it again.
It was long and forward. Lovely bit of skill. Tadic. Burton. Holding on to the slenderest of leads, with time ebbing away. Wanyama. Passes it through. He's made sure that that won't get through.
Well, maybe they're settling for what they have, because they're not going to score from there.
Bournemouth are minutes away from a notable win. Bertrand gets into the right position to intercept. Looks to slip it through. What an adventurous run from a defender. Bournemouth just have to run down the clock. Added time is up, and there goes the whistle. Bournemouth get off to a winning start. It bodes well for what promises to be another exciting season. Well, after all of that, Jim, what are you thinking?
Yeah, the players always like to win the first game of the campaign, and they've done it in good style with that win.
So just time for me to say thanks to Jim for his wisdom and to wish... Hello and a warm welcome to everyone across the globe. We should be underway very shortly. The players will be with us any time now. The teams then, Bournemouth against Newcastle. This is Peter Drury and I'm happy to inform you that Jim Beglin has joined me to offer his expertise.
Hello Peter and hello to everyone watching. For me, it's a real thrill to be here.
We go then. Jim, you've played in games of this nature. Who can make the difference?
I would say the embodiment of consistency, Fabrizio Colaccini, an organizer and leader and someone who sets the example for work rate and wholehearted effort, which is always appreciated, and usually everybody else responds to it too.
Okay, interesting. And it's a goal!
Well, when the game's played like that, it's made to look very simple. You know, I love watching football like this. Easy, effective, 1-2 and bang. Thanks very much.
The romantic feel of a potential upset, but it is far too early to get carried away yet. Spoon forward. Bournemouth picked up three valuable points on opening day, and now a chance to build on that. Coleman. Kenwyn Jones! He scores! With the match still in its infancy, they are easing away. Jim, your thoughts?
Well, we've just seen intelligent football from intelligent footballers. That's honed on the training ground and lovely when it comes off on match day.
It is two now and the shock is very much on. Who's going to make this theirs? Over hit and out of play. Bournemouth are already cruising here. 2-0, a fabulous start. Coleman. Bournemouth are out in front, sitting pretty already. This is promising. Kenwyn Jones.
He's gone for it! They are running riot! Hot knife through butter! They have done it again!
Look, there just wasn't much of a gap to begin with, and to find it, I think it was a fine drive, and I don't think the keeper could have really planned for that. I think he's a bit unlucky in that instance.
Bournemouth take a 3-goal lead and they are romping out of sight. Williamson. Colback. Williamson. A quick ball here. Where to from here? And it's Cabella. Cabella tries to head towards goal. Keeper's not concerned by that.
The defence was made to look vulnerable there. They simply had no answer for that trickery.
It's been intercepted and that will come to nothing. Jan Mat tries to get it forward quickly. Towards the front line, and he's onside. Bournemouth have themselves a corner, I think. Yes, they do. Into a dangerous position. Loose ball, who's going to get there? Bournemouth leading with half-time drawing close. Coleman.
He'll have a dip!
The ball's come loose and the chase is on. Side really getting hold of the ball. Ball's loose, who's getting there? Fine defending there. He's on the charge, but he's on his own for now.
And in it goes! They are running riot here!
Bournemouth tear their opponents apart once again. They are utterly ruthless. Aimed long and direct. And the whistle goes for half-time. What have we learned from the first 45 minutes?
Bournemouth have just played a terrific 45 minutes of football, but they may well have to produce a repeat second half now to see this through. I think the going is going to get a lot tougher, so these players are going to need to dig in now to get this result.
Bournemouth have run riot in the first half, and barring a miraculous comeback, they have done the job already. Dion. Cabella, and the through ball is intercepted. Cissé. Oh, he's broken through.
Well, he had the chance to release it left and ended up making the wrong choice by going it alone. He just took on way too many there, and he's got to think about that a little bit more and make a better decision.
Now it's Jones. It's Kenwyn Jones! Oh, superb from Kenwyn Jones! Ruthless and relentless, utterly rampant. Absolutely thundered in. Keeper, no chance.
Is it just me, or did he make that look very, very easy? That was terrific skill and composure from him. He finished with such aplomb.
Snaffles his third, and that earns him the match ball.
Oh, this has been an immense contribution from one player. He's been just about unplayable. The irresistible force today.
Bournemouth totally rampant here. Passes it through. Kenwyn Jones! Oh, he really got hold of that.
You know what you need when you get in those positions is composure and coolness. And he just didn't show enough of it.
It so nearly came off for him.
Yeah, he's definitely a player who looks like he could make something happen every time he's on the ball. He's just full of belief and energy. Everything they would have spoken about in that dressing room during the break has a greater chance of happening. The early goal. It's the perfect platform now to go to win it.
Kenwyn Jones. Bournemouth cannot keep hold of the ball. Big chance! Really well taken goal!
Look, there just wasn't much of a gap to begin with, and to find it, I think it was a fine drive, and I don't think the keeper could have really planned for that. I think he's a bit unlucky in that instance.
Four in the game, he is the man. Cissé. Bournemouth get dipped into their subs. Yeah, Matt. They really are proving themselves to be solid all over the field. Colaccini. It's a long ball, and it's not hit its target. He won't reach that. Tries lifting it over. Oh, superb from Kenwyn Jones!
I just think he showed a lovely appreciation of where that defensive line formed, and he held his run until just the right moment, and he broke the offside trap, and he took full advantage. That's top marks for me.
How many more does he want? There's going to be a change here. There's a man waiting to come on.
Number 4.
Tiote.
Coming on the field is number 8.
Coleman. Still a little short of forward momentum, lacking thrust. Tiote tries to switch the play. It's long. For a moment you felt that was going somewhere, but they'll have to go again. Coleman. Like a good ball through. Kenwyn Jones
with a shot. They've done it.
Kenwyn Jones simply wasn't going to decline an invitation like that. He knows that they've got the passers in this side that will find them, and his job was just to make sure he didn't stray offside, and it worked an absolute treat.
Tiote, Colaccini, Cabella, Tiote, promising cross.
They didn't manage to get nearly enough into the box, and that speaks of little ambition.
Kenwyn Jones with a long pass out wide. Oh, he's managed to get himself offside. And it's Sissoko. The pass. And that'll be a goal kick. Moussa Sissoko looking cross field, changing the point of attack. Siem Diol. Oh, he's come up against the brick wall there. And time is up. A demolition, destruction, annihilation. They simply ran away with it. So, Jim, how do you reflect on what we've seen?
Well, listen, if you've got that kind of power and that kind of pace in your team, I think you'll plough through most teams. Those central areas tend to be very congested, lots of traffic going on, but it wasn't a problem for them.
And all that remains for me is to thank Jim Beglin. That's it. to you all. I'm glad to say the game is back again. If you needed reminding, it's time to fasten those seatbelts for the endless roller coaster ride that is to come. Birmingham against Southampton. This is Peter Drury, and next to me providing insights will be Jim Beglin.
Well, thanks for that, Peter. I'm more than ready to get going here.
Birmingham against Southampton. Thrill to witness the start of a brand new managerial career. What a day this is for him. Jim, what do you think of his prospects?
Well, I have to admit, Peter, that I didn't see this appointment coming. There were other candidates with bigger reputations, but he's obviously impressed upon the powers that be that he can deliver what they want. And good luck to him.
So what now? Looks like a good ball through. Puts it into the middle. That's been repelled. Out wide to the right. Promising cross. Defence has got rid of that. And he's through on goal. He's one on one. Play, and it is a goal kick. Good determined running there, but one back by the defence. He's ruffled a few feathers, but well dealt with. Southampton putting their opponents under a lot of pressure in the early stages. Good idea, just poorly executed. Has a swing at it! Great build-up. It all deserved a better ending.
And it just goes to show you how effective those through balls can be. All it needed was a better execution.
Tries a through ball. He's scored!
Yeah, I love the finish, but I think had the pass been delayed for just a second longer, I think he would have been flagged offside. And I think you have to praise them all round on that one, from the pass and the finish.
Southampton take the lead.
Well, that's put him in the driving seat, but there's a lot of football left in this one yet, believe me.
Floats one over. Oh, and they really should have been made to pay. Southampton enjoying a good spell right now and leading. So they got the only goal to make it 1-0. Crunching tackle. Oh, he's come flying in. He's gone for it, and the ball's come out. where he wants it. For a moment you felt that was going somewhere, but they'll have to go again. Now the pass. That's offside. Yes, it is. Has got good distance on that. Away from immediate danger. Goes for goal! Back of the net! Looking safe. That was glorious. Pinpoint accuracy.
Well, once upon a time I was harsh on goalkeepers, but now as the ball moves all over the place these days, and we've just seen it again.
Southampton have a couple of goals without reply. It's 2-0.
That second goal has such a polarising effect on prospective moods. I mean, one team are under more pressure now to get the next goal, and the other will fancy their chances of turning 2 into 3.
It's a throw. Birmingham have a free kick. We've got 5 minutes till half time. Promising, but eventually without doing harm. It's got through, and well, he would surely have scored there more times than not. Knocks it towards the front. That'll be the last act of the first half. Southampton ahead 2-0, and they are looking good. And we're off again. Into the middle. Loose ball, who's going to get there? Fine defending there. That really should have hit the net.
What an effort that was. He's done very well from that distance.
Deftly done. And out to safety. Oh, Southampton are two up. It's gone out for a throw in. Promising move that, good inroads into enemy territory, but no joy. Needless to say, he was expecting a better ball than that. It was long and forward. Southampton are looking now to close out the game. It through, clears it out of harm's way, looking to get within range. He's got away with one there. A piece of really good defending. Going forward, how does he try from here? Has he found his man? It's been intercepted, and that will come to nothing. Gets it upfield. He's on the move, and he's going to have to go it alone.
Oh, listen, I think you can understand at times that the pace of the game pressures players into split-second decisions, and sometimes they just make the wrong one, and I think he would have been better placing that.
Oh, you could tell he really wanted that.
Well, there's no doubt that the whole team revolves around him now. He leads by example, and he's become the main pivot. Cracking player.
Look like 3-0 for sure.
And if they don't get the job done from here, he'll look back on that moment and know he should have made it a 3-goal cushion. Should have finished things off.
Forward it goes. Is threatening to become a really good game.
I think they've done so well to get back in it, but it's important now that they don't become over-eager in chasing another. They only need one more chance. Patience is key.
Out to the flank. Whipped in. He's going to have to tune his rangefinder before the next one. It's in! And surely that does it! Perfect time! Decisive strike! Southampton from two up and into a position of real strength. he's off on a marauding run. Well, he would surely have scored there more times than not. It is all over. Southampton have their win on opening day. The season perfectly teed up. Your reflections then, Jim?
Well, listen, it's always good to win the first match of a campaign. It's important for the manager and the players to get off to a good start, and they've done exactly that today.
That's it for tonight's match. So it just remains for me to thank Jim Beglin alongside me and to wish you all a very... Hello and a warm welcome to everyone across the globe. We should be underway very shortly. The players will be with us anytime now. And our live game is Bolton against Southampton. I'm Peter Drury and it's a pleasure to be alongside Jim Beglin.
Thanks, Peter. Hello, everybody. I'm ready to see what unfolds in this one now.
Well played, he saw that coming. Boom forward. There's a move that looked promising, but eventually thwarted without doing any harm. Bolton lost on the opening day, so coming to this already looking to make up ground. On the left-hand side now to profit from it. So what now? Fair to say, I think a cautious start from both teams. And it's Lafondre. Looks like a good ball through. Clears it out of harm's way. A chance! Oh, terrific run to latch onto it, but the finish is all wrong.
And it just goes to show you how effective those through balls can be. All it needed was a better execution.
It is still 0-0. Both sides a bit lacking in intent. Gets it into the middle. No, he couldn't get the direction he needed.
Bolton didn't really deal with the wide play. It was a lovely dribble down the flank, but really they've got to double up to try and stop that. And I think with the attempted goal too, they were a little fortunate.
Ball's out on the left now. Aimed in towards the centre. Bolton to retain the ball, but seemingly in no rush to break forward. Did well to step in there, that was more than necessary. Out towards the flank. Real chance! Ball. Who's going to get there? Shot at goal! He's got away with one there. Southampton. About it patiently, perhaps too patiently. Tries a through ball, hits one!
To be fair, that was tough for the keeper to handle.
It's the route one option. Still waiting for the first goal. Brings it forward. Shoots! Well, he would surely have scored there more times than not. Half time getting close now. Passes it through. And through to the goalkeeper. He's had a look, and he's blown his whistle for half-time. Any strong opinions on the first half?
Well, they've never really been threatened in the first half. I think it's been a magnificent team effort. The work rate has been superb. Very, very organised.
No goals at this stage, but certainly not devoid of action. It is 0-0 here at half-time. And we're off again. 0-0 then, and we're back on the way. Out to the flank, tries to pick out a teammate. Oh, taken with style! And finally, he has breathed life into the game. An absolute gem of a cross. It made the header simple.
Well, look, it's often the timing of the jump that dictates what you can do with any header, and if you get it slightly wrong, then you'll struggle, but that was beautifully met, it really was.
Deadlock broken, it's 1-0.
Well, whatever the manager said in that dressing room at half-time, it's worked a treat.
Just as well the defender was on hand to mop up the loose ball.
Yeah. Is there any support? He might not need it. Oh, and they really should have been made to pay. It so nearly came off for him.
Well, there's no doubt that the whole team revolves around him now. He leads by example, and he's become the main pivot. Cracking player.
Well, that's a foul. Free kick's been given.
Everything they would have spoken about in that dressing room during the break has a greater chance of happening thanks to the early goal. It's the perfect platform now to go on and try to win it.
Shoots! Good strong hand by the keeper. Southampton claiming a corner and the referee concurs. To get it away. Southampton scoring early in the second half to make it 1-0. He's good for it!
Well, for me, he had a very decent crack at it, but it has to be said that the odds on those from distance were never really that good, and it always favoured the keeper in that instance.
Southampton had to make a change here. Towards the front. They really are proving themselves to be solid all over the field. Plays it out to the wing. Looks to slip it through. Has a swing at it! Great build-up. It all deserved a better ending.
Yeah, and that was all about the through ball. Great control, and the weight was perfect.
Oh, you could tell he really wanted that.
He's just a nightmare for any defence. His movement, his pace, his anticipation, it's on another level. It's so hard for any defence to contain that.
It's long and forward. Another piece of really good defending. Almost 75 minutes on the clock now. Very well to intervene. Into the channel. The shot's on! Fair effort, he reacted well.
Well, the defence really needs to have that closed down. They were able to get the centre in far too easily.
It's a promising run he's making on the right. Tries a through ball, has a shot, no mistake, two to the good, they have breathing space. Well, from right in front of goal, there was no way he was going to miss.
Well, we've just seen intelligent football from intelligent footballers that's honed on the training ground and lovely when it comes off on match day.
Bolton, have a sub ready to come on.
Well, for me, this was the obvious substitution. He'd become just a little jaded, and as a result of that, he was most likely to make a mistake. I think sometimes when the body becomes tired, the brain goes with it, and I think that's happened in this case.
Southampton have a couple of goals without reply. It's 2-0. Southampton still 2-0 up and looking now to see it through. Good running with the ball, can they build on it? He's had a shot! It's a loose ball. Comes sliding in. He's got away with one there. The pass and out to safety. Oh, he's come up against a brick wall there. Still going, where to next? Oh, no shortage of confidence there.
Well, he knew he needed a better angle to get a shot away, and I suppose at least he showed the best option, just didn't come off.
There he is, making his presence felt.
Well, he's certainly a player I'd be more than happy to watch. Tactically, he's almost impossible to stop.
Fine defending there. And that's it. Southampton did it. Terrific team effort to satisfy both the boss and the fans. How do you look back on the game then, Jim?
What I most admire about this outfit is the cohesion and the willingness to work hard as a unit, getting behind the ball, doing the ugly stuff. That's what gets you clean sheets and wins.
Well, that's the lot for now. Thanks to you, Jim.